But I remember last April when the flu pandemic, so to speak, first raised its ugly, evil head, and how I felt, and I sense that you felt the same way, that there was a dark curtain being lowered over freedom and liberty, that we were very close at that time. You lost one or two of your main websites, that they were all...
No, we were definitely officially hacked. That was 100% certified.
They were ready to shut everything down. They can do that again. I feel that this is what, in their dark, evil layers of the low and mighty, that they're actually laughing at everything that we do around 9/11, everything that everyone says about the truth of it over the last 8 years right up to today, including Charlie Sheen, because they have this tremendous flu pandemic ace in the hole card, which is going to shut everything down, and none of it will matter as far as other areas of dissension such as 9/11 are concerned. And I think that they figured they've already got the game won, and that the attention that needs to be drawn to the poison that's in these vaccinations should be the number one priority. Because
I hear you, and I appreciate your call. I mean, we've been having doctors on two or three times a week. I talked about it yesterday. I've broken it down. I've warned people. I don't want to say we've had a victory, but they were saying they were going to vaccinate everybody forcibly. Now they've backed off and say only 50 million people. They are setting up all the martial law stuff in place, and we've warned the public and police and firemen and medical workers and nurses. The majority in all these news articles and polls are saying they're not taking it. So I'm not saying we're out of the woods, but we're in the fight here. And we've got to expose false flag terror. We've got to expose the youth brigades. We've got to expose the new Bank of the World, the plunging dollar. We've got to, I mean, you know, this show's a four-hour show. I'm here covering all the issues. And I'm hitting it all as quick and as fast and as good as I can. Doesn't mean I'm perfect. But I do hear your points. Let's talk to Dustin in Illinois. Dustin, go ahead.
How's you doing?
Good.
Yeah, I've both seen you on NWO documentary, and I've been listening to you ever since. My wife's grandma, she was in the hospital. They diagnosed her with cancer. She's 97 years old. She has not had any vaccinations since she was a kid. My wife told me about it. I said, that's not true. You know, she hasn't had any vaccinations. She can't have cancer. And I insisted that they do another check. They checked it. It turned out to be scar tissue.
Well, that's great. Yeah, I've seen numbers of as much as 45% of the time happened to my grandmother. Scar tissue in a lung, cut her lung out, messed her heart up, ended up killing her a few years later. I've got one precious grandmother left, and they tried to chop a bunch of her off. She said no, and she's alive 3-4 years later, and it turned out it wasn't really what they said. All of this goes on. But no, you can get cancer without taking vaccines. I mean, that happens to all mammal species. It's just the prevalence of cancer has gone from 1 in 33 in the 50s to 1 in 3, it's about to be 1 in 2, getting cancer and dying from it. So it's toxins in the environment, it's vaccines, it's a cocktail of things, but that's great news that it turned out it was scar tissue.
Another thing, I was going to school for law enforcement, and my Russian's teacher, he showed us a video about eugenics.
Hold on, stay there. I want to come back to you after this quick break. I'm trying to get an update right now from Charlie Sheen. Stay with us.